Solving the country's agriculture woes also addresses food supply disruptions, inflationary food prices, and the lack of participation by the agriculture sector to nation building. But that has the Marcos administration achieved that? Danilo Fausto, president of the Philippine Chamber of Agriculture and Food Incorporated, is with us on the show for some insight on agriculture from yesterday's SONA. Good afternoon, Mr. Fausto, and welcome to Business Roadshow.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon.
All right. First off, what did you like most about the way the president tackled your sector, both speech and reality?
Well, all in all, we are happy because more than 30% of his time in the SONA was devoted to agriculture.
Okay.
That will just reflect the importance and the priority given by this government to the development of the agriculture sector, which was not present in the past administrations, past decades, because we were all neglected. Now, but there are items in his speech that we like, and there are items that we feel that needs to be improved, or shall we say, work in progress.
Okay.
And some are motherhood statements, because it's understandable, because the details will be spelled out when he is in the office in the Department of Agriculture.
Okay, taking away the motherhood statements, what did you like?
Well, we like, first of all, the move to amend the fisheries code and make a science-based as basis for determining the fisheries area. Mm-hmm. One of our sector, the fisheries sector in our chamber, has been clamoring to, instead of the 15 kilometer from the shore, determining the municipal waters, it has to be based on by PATHOM, by science based, so that those fishes that cannot be caught by the municipal fishermen can be taken in by the commercial fishers. That means from 5 kilometers to 10 kilometers, these fishes just die there because the municipal fishermen cannot do it. That's the number one. Number two is we're happy about the Katiwa. The expansion of the Katiwa stores that brings a mitigating aspect in terms of runaway prices on markets and on traders. We support that. And also it gives also the cooperatives a store or a place to put their products directly without passing to the traders.
Okay.
Yeah,
another one that would perhaps benefit the agriculture sector is the amendments to the Anti-Smuggling Act, which is, of course, the root cause of a lot of inflationary pressures, particularly increases in food prices that we've experienced in the Philippines recently. Are you happy about that?
Yes, we would like to have more punishment. There's a lot of cases that were filed and some of those that were caught smuggling, but there are no conviction. We want to see some conviction. It's not just a matter of filing a case against them. We need to there's nobody in got caught in smuggling that went to jail. We want to see more teeth on the law, Stanley.
All right, Mr. Fausto, a lot of people were wondering about the 20 peso per kilo rice, which was the campaign promise. There was no mention about it in the SONA yesterday. Even the journey towards 20 pesos would have been nice to hear. Are prices of rice really going down at the very least?
Well, at the moment, because of the pressure in the international market and also our productivity, we have not reached that level of sufficiency. I don't think the prices of rice can go down. Even the rice millers who promised a 38 per kilo, I don't know how they can sustain these prices. So the problem, Stanley, is the agriculture sector has been in growing at about 0.8% for the past 10 years. Okay. And our population is at 1.5 to 1.6%. If our growth in agriculture cannot surpass the population growth, the supply will always be a problem. And when you have a problem supply, then you there's a problem on prices, Stanley.
Okay, now speaking of problems in supply, here's another one. There's this worrisome global development that may affect food supply. India and Vietnam, for one, have indicated cuts in rice exports, for instance, prioritizing their own domestic consumers before supplying to other countries. Now, what would you have wanted to hear from the president about this, as we do not have resources, really, not even the time to double down on local rice production to fit that demand?
Well, the anticipation of Vietnam and India on the El Nino, I think, is the culprit on this. And I think the president can do on a government-to-government arrangement, perhaps, to make sure that our supply of imported rice will not be cut down, because majority of our rice imports are coming from Vietnam. They're also will be suffering from El Nino, and they are protecting their own domestic consumers on this supply requirement, Stanley.
Okay, let's talk about agriculture modernization now, although it is not fair to expect really trailblazing modernization just 1 year into the presidency. But are you seeing gains in terms of how programs are designed or even resources are allocated or dedicated to agriculture modernization?
That's the thing, Stanley. That's the thing that we did not hear from the president. The basic is the data information system, the available real-time, reliable data. Because if you cannot measure it, we cannot manage it. It's been since 1997. The modernization will involve the data. Digitalization through perhaps satellite geotagging and the drone can provide the demand supply and the areas that are planted and prices. We need those data, reliable data. If you go to Congress, to Senate, even in Malacanang, they do not know what kind of data they were going to use because they are not sure of the data they're using. We need to make sure that we have a reliable data. That is how to modernize our agriculture so that we can plan better on what to plant and what to import and then what prices will go up because of low supply. And then we can anticipate and be proactive on all these things, Sandy.
All right. Lastly, Mr. Fausto, given, of course, the time of just 5 years, that's not a lot left for the presidency, and assuming that the administration does its job to uphold the agriculture sector. Realistically now, what can this administration achieve if all goes as planned in the next 5 years?
We see a good growth for the agriculture sector, but we need more time for the president in office. You know, for 1 year, there's only once that he went to the office of the Department of Agriculture. He needs to do and make command and do marching orders and make sure that he monitors it, and performance indicators will be monitored so that the timeline and the deadlines and the development will be done, you know, and make sure that the budgets are there and that it's downloaded properly. So I think the devil really is on the detail. There's so much things that has to be done, but the president needs to give more time to agriculture, to his office as a Secretary of Agriculture.
Okay, and having said,
he cannot isolate himself in all the other industries like DTI, DILG, the DOST. So these things has to be with convergence. He can do this as president so that he can move the development of agriculture, Stanley.
Okay, so do we really need a new agriculture secretary now, given all those you mentioned?
No, not really, but because there's nobody who can do and have the convergence, having the DTI for marketing and promotion, DOST for research, DILG in the downloading, and the frontliners, and then you have the FDA for the permits and Bureau of Customs. There's so many agencies involved in this, including the Department of Agrarian Reform. I've heard about the Emancipation Act, but I'm worried about he might commit the same mistake as us before of delivering the support services, the details on how to deliver the support services, because we cannot leave this agrarian beneficiaries, reform beneficiaries alone. We need their, the support services has to be there. It's been promised, but we don't see the details, the implementing mechanism, Stanley.
All right. On that note, we end this interview. Thank you so much for your time, your thoughts, and being part of this conversation, Mr. Danilo Fausto, President of the Philippine Chamber of Agriculture and Food Incorporated. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you, Stanley.